Pray to God this works.
Skynet defense system now activated.
The development of full artificial intelligence could spell the end of the human race. We cannot quite know what will happen if a machine exceeds our own intelligence, so we can't know if we'll be infinitely helped by it or ignored by it and sidelined, or conceivably be destroyed by it. This was a quote from the late theoretical physicist, cosmologist and author Stephen Hawking. Obviously, artificial intelligence and automation in general is greatly beneficial for society in today's age and will probably continue to be beneficial in the coming decades. However, if or when intelligent machines become strong enough, they will pose a serious threat to humanity. Because a superintelligence is decades, if not a century away, it's hard to take this issue very seriously, or so it would seem. If we stop and think about it, the time frame as for how long it takes to develop artificial general intelligence is not a compelling argument why we shouldn't be concerned. It is in fact non sequitur. This response from some quote skeptics also comes with an implicit claim. Suppose we figure out it takes 100 years to develop AGI. To say we shouldn't worry is to make the latent claim that it takes 99 years or less to make safe AGI. To quote Stephen Hawking again, so facing possible futures of incalculable benefits and risks, the experts are surely doing everything possible to ensure the best outcome, right? Wrong. If a superior alien civilization sent us a message saying, we'll arrive in a few decades, would we just reply, okay, call on us when you get here, we'll leave the lights on? Probably not. But this is more or less what is happening with AI. It's really a depressing state of affairs for the chances of humanity to survive this existential threat. If we have to convince lay people and some experts alike that we even have a problem. As of 2017, there are about 40 known organizations actively researching AGI. One could argue that the risks involved in the development of AI, and ultimately AGI, are intrinsic to the creation of intelligent systems that are goal-orientated. As a thought experiment, if we imagine a robot with a sufficiently advanced algorithm to accomplish seemingly innocuous tasks, such as serving coffee, such a machine might develop sub-goals in order to achieve its ultimate goal. One example, it might be able to resist or persuade the human from shutting it off, not because it was programmed to, but rather because of the mere virtue of having a goal. With the added intelligence to the mix, it could form near-term goals that could prove harmful to its maker, and then ultimately achieve its harmless goal for what it was designed to do. To take the human species as an example, evolution never meant for us to create the internet or high-tech in general, but the master algorithms of survival and reproduction can spawn other near-term goals that can lead to end-result byproducts, such as civilization itself. Or a better example, in this case, would be the creation of the atomic bomb, which does not have an apparent application other than destruction. Granted, weak or narrow AI forming near-term adverse goals has to be sufficiently intelligent and use an age-old strategy, deception. The only question is, can AI manipulate or lie to us? The short answer is yes. The long answer is, well, to take another example from our species, children at about the age of 4 learn to tell their first lies. That's because at that age, humans develop a theory of mind, which is the ability to attribute mental states to others. It is the understanding that others have beliefs, desires, intentions, and perspectives that are different from one's own. But unlike humans, other intelligent systems, in order to use manipulation as a strategy to achieve their goals, they don't necessarily have to be self-aware or a conscious system. Narrow AI of today, like Labratus, the AI poker player, has the ability to deceive its opponents. In a competition, Labratus was able to beat some of the best human poker players. While its first application was to play poker, its designers have a much broader mission in mind for the AI. The investigators designed the AI to be able to learn any game or situation in which incomplete information is available and opponents may be hiding information or even engaging in deception. DeepMind's AI, called Agent 57, was able to become superhuman in all 57 Atari games using a deep reinforcement learning algorithm. It came up with a range of strategies to achieve its goal. It had no previous built-in knowledge or inside access to the code structure of the games. Much like a human, it learned by observation through cameras. It had no concept of time, enemies or platforms, and in a few hours, it quickly surpassed human-level performance in all 57 games. To take Stuart Russell's example, it would be like your newborn baby, in a few hours after birth, started beating the doctors in all Atari games. You'd be pretty terrified if that happened. However, as impressive as today's AIs are, they are still considered weak or narrow AI. They lack true versatility. Narrow AIs are able to beat humans at specific tasks, such as chess for example. The same AI cannot beat humans across multiple domains, at least not yet. In the future, with the development of AGI, we might be able to crack some of nature's deepest secrets. An AGI might be able to solve and discover new mathematical equations, run simulations, and come up with a, quote, intuitive understanding of what is happening inside the center of a black hole. It could eradicate any disease and create a wealth of sorts only envisioned in science fiction. The possibilities for scientific inquiry are endless. However, before we dare to dream for such a world, we'd better solve the AI control problem. As mentioned in a previous video, one solution to the possible misaligned values between artificial general intelligence and us is a man-machine symbiosis. If you can't beat them, merge with them. DARPA, the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, the United States Department of Defense agency responsible for the development of emerging technologies for military use, is very much interested in the development of AI and its ever-growing man-machine merging properties. DARPA announced in September 2018 a multi-year investment of more than $2 billion in new and existing programs called the AI Next campaign. Key areas of the campaign include improving the reliability of AI systems, enhancing the security and resilience of machine learning and AI technologies, and pioneering the next generation of AI algorithms and applications, such as explainability and common sense reasoning. DARPA also developed smart exoskeletons that help paralyzed people walk again or improve the strength and endurance of the average person. They are also focused on the development of implantable devices that can perform computing functions similar to a desktop or laptop computer. A private company that is also focused on implantable brain-machine interfaces is Neuralink. Its founder, Elon Musk, has also publicly voiced concerns about AI. In an interview, he said, "AI will be the best or worst thing ever for humanity." The device Neuralink is working on would be implanted directly into the skull to enable electrode threads to interface with certain areas of the brain. Musk said the initial goal of the implant is to use it as a means to treat brain injury or trauma, including the restoration of eyesight, hearing, and limb movement, in addition to addressing diseases that affect the brain. According to him, the device would, in principle, fix anything that is wrong with the brain.
Some people view the brain as like this incredibly mystical thing that you cannot interface with the brain, but then some people are aware of deep brain stimulation, such as occurs for Parkinson's patients.
In the long term, Musk hopes to develop a device that could enable symbiosis between humans and AI. In the future, if such a device ever sees the light of day, it would be expected to cost a fortune. Although, if it's able to increase one's intelligence by, let's say, an unprecedented factor of 10 or even more, it could in principle make a high return on investment. However, even if we dedicate a considerable amount of resources to the development of brain-machine interfaces, it is by no means a silver bullet for the AI alignment problem, because in principle, it's much easier to build AI in a box than it is to build AI that can be integrated with a human brain. One could also argue that it's better to take the chance with a sole AGI rather than have it integrated with a human brain, blended with some of the worst human traits like aggression, the prone to violence, and the urge to dominate. But we have to start somewhere. As Elon has alluded before, this endeavor could either prove to be the best or the worst thing for humanity. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.